Welcome to the Easy Coordinator Quick Start video part 2. In this short video, I'm going to give you an overview of your dashboard as well as an overview of a transaction page. So once you've logged in, you're going to see a little summary tab here at the top. This is going to give you an overview of all the activity within your pipeline. In addition, you're going to have a Schedule Tasks tab. This is going to list all of your tasks for all of your transactions. And you can sort this by any of the columns at the top. In addition, if you want to clear or mark complete any of these tasks, just click on the little checkbox to the left. And these will be marked complete within your transaction. Below is a list of all your current transactions. You're going to see the active statuses by default. So active, pending, and contingent listings, as well as any buyers you're working with. On your transaction specific information, we're going to show you some information about your file. Below that is going to be a tasks tab. This shows me all the tasks for this specific transaction that have been completed, marked with a blue check mark, and the ones with a red exclamation point have not yet been completed. And then your notes section, which will give you a quick overview of any recent notes on the file. And to edit or work within a transaction, we'll click the little blue pen button. And this is your main transaction page. All of your transaction info will be on this page. Your information about the property at the top, your transaction-specific email address for emailing documents and notes, the Easy Share function, which allows you to share this transaction with any party you'd like, as well as an option to print a green sheet or a summary transaction sheet. Below that is your transaction info, all of your pricing information, all of your important dates, buyer, seller, agent information, as well as your commissions. Below that is the additional info section, and this is where you can track customized fields that you've created. Next is additional contacts, where you can keep track of any additional parties to the transaction, such as contractor or escrow officer, or anybody you'd like. Below that is your document folders. This is where I'm going to keep all of my documents stored. I've got various different folders so I can keep them organized. And to move documents within the document folder, you just drag them into whatever folder they belong in. Below that, we have our task section. And here's a list of all of my tasks. The ones with a line through them have been marked complete. And then this task has a document attached to it. And this is a great way to keep track of documents that are associated with a specific task. And below that is the notes section where you can enter notes such as signed listing agreement or met with seller, as well as see any activity within the file, and also see a list of any emails that you might have emailed into the system to the transaction specific email address. And you can delete the transaction from here as well as request a backup. A few other features are your calendar. Your calendar is going to list every due date that you have set within all transactions. You can filter it by the transaction type or by the date. In addition, you can sync it to your Google Calendar in all premium accounts. And finally, the document review feature. This is where, as a broker or office manager, you can review documents for compliance. You'll have a list of your document task lists for each transaction. And you can preview them, add notes, or mark them approved. And that is the end of quick start video number two for Easy Coordinator. We have lots of videos which go into each of these features in great detail on our YouTube page. And of course, if you have any questions at all, please feel free to contact us at any time for assistance.